FlexiLayout alternatives. We'll learn about this very powerful feature. We'll focus on FlexiLayout alternative use cases, how to create FlexiLayout alternatives, and how they're matched. And finally, we'll talk about mapping blocks in FlexiLayout alternatives. There's certainly a best practice there. So you can use FlexiLayout alternatives when documents coming in are of the same type. They have the same information. The documents are processed identically and in the same language. And there are several variations of field arrangements. So one supplier, or even more than one supplier, could provide documents with the same data, but different layouts. And the process designer creates a simple FlexiLayout alternative for each variant, instead of building one complicated FlexiLayout to match all variants. So when one supplier provides similar types of documents, the information is the same, the layout differs, and that's certainly something that comes up. Depending on your skill level, if you can build that complicated layout quickly on your own, perhaps that's the best approach. But if people coming in after you need to understand simple layouts, then using a layout alternative is a great way to go. If the document types vary greatly, you can use the classifier to help distinguish those variants. So this is what FlexiLayout alternatives look like. We've got at our top level Inaton Inc., and then that was cloned for Debron Manufacture, which was cloned for Chronicle Solutions. Each alternative has its own search element branch, so you can see they've each got their own header and footer. And each alternative must have strong identifiers. Alternative layouts are independent. Elements of one branch cannot refer to elements of another branch. Think of them as firewalled. So the steps to creating a FlexiLayout alternative could vary because there's different methods for creating layout alternatives. The first one outlined here is to use the shortcut menu, and you simply add a FlexiLayout alternative. The second one is interesting. You can import a FlexiLayout. You essentially import an entire FlexiLayout as a layout alternative into your existing FlexiLayout Studio project. So I use this feature when I want to, say, parse an address. I have a different layout. That's all that that layout does. And if that need comes about, I will import that layout as a layout alternative, and then I'll drag it into my main layout. But you can also just import different layouts to be used as layout alternatives. And finally, my favorite way to create layout alternatives is to hold down the control key and your left mouse button and drag the current layout down. And it will then create a copy, a clone of your layout. And then you go in and you make the changes first to the header, footer if needed as well. And then you make just those changes to different elements to read the data from this new source, which is causing you to create the layout alternative in the first place. So we can take a look at what the menu looks like. If you want to import an alternate element, you can see on the right that that structure is illustrated. It's very simple to do. And the order of matching the alternatives is important. You want to put your high volume layout alternatives up top and your low volumes on the bottom. And you can drag and drop, rearrange them as needed. Don't forget to specify a unique ID element in each alternative so that you can understand what it's trying to match. But we do top-down matching. So that's why you want to put it in that order. And as soon as it matches one of the layout alternatives, it's going to stop. It's not going to double check lower to see if there's a better match. So it's very important to have strong headers and footers so that everything gets identified correctly. It's also very important to map all of your blocks. When you are intending to create a layout alternative, map all your blocks first. And then when you clone the layout alternative, the clone will have everything mapped for you. So I once worked on a project for all 50 states in the United States. It had 45 fields, and so I created the layout for the first state in the United States, mapped all my fields, and then I cloned it, and then I started working on the second state. But I saw that because I initially mapped everything before cloning, that my clone copy had everything mapped already. So if I had forgotten to do that and completed all 50 states without having done any mapping, I would have had to map 45 fields one at a time for each of the 50 states. That would have been a real waste of time. So make sure that you verify that all blocks for all layout alternatives are mapped before you export. And a quick visual cue is to look at your blocks, and if there's an empty square in the upper right-hand corner, that means that that block has not been mapped. So you want to create FlexiLayout alternatives when the fields on your documents have the same type of processing rules and all the documents are in the same language, but the data locations are different. And this is an alternative approach to creating one complicated layout that can understand all sorts of variations. And if you want to just keep things simple for other people who have to come in behind you, this could be a good approach. Sometimes you just don't want to invest the time to create a very complex and flexible layout. This is a way it could be to save some time. So FlexiLayout alternatives are independent one from another. You can't refer to elements from one layout alternative to another. They can't be linked. You must remember to block all alternatives, each block in every alternative. And my tip there is to map all your blocks before you clone your first layout into a layout alternative. If you do that, all the mapping will be done for you. And remember that matching is done in order from top to bottom. If there's more than one layouts that could be matched, it's going to match the first one and stop right there. So it's important to put stuff in the right order. Put things in the order from most frequently occurring to least frequently occurring.